So I literally have no skills or experience when it comes to making or creating motion graphics. Well, recently, SVGator reached out to me and they wanted me to review their product and see if I can actually create some motion graphics myself without any previous experience. I'm going to give you my upfront and my most honest opinion on SVGator and show you how I managed to animate a simple graphic without any previous experience with motion graphics. So like I mentioned, I have no experience with animating SVGs before today's video. SVGator, however, has made the experience so incredibly easy that I was actually really surprised. Now, I'm going to keep things completely 100 with you guys today, and this is my upfront and my honest opinion on SVGator. Now, you can try the free version and then move to the paid version if you do find it useful. However, the free version still offers all of the advanced features, but when you export or preview the SVG in a browser, the advanced features will only be in use with the paid version. And one thing I found super helpful is that SVGator has a set of tutorials on their website. They're incredibly easy to follow, and this is why I was able to learn how to animate an SVG in under an hour. You can make a new project, or you can simply upload the SVG file, which is what I'm going to do. Now, I did make a very quick icon in Adobe Illustrator, and it's made completely of stroke lines with no color fills. So taking the arrow tool, I can click each part of my SVG design that are made up of two stroke paths. Now to set up an animation timeline, you need to come down here to this button, and for stroke designs, you're going to need to select both the stroke offset option and also the stroke dashes option. So this is my timeline, and it runs in seconds from left to right, much like you would find in video editing software. So let's go ahead and animate this SVG by the triangle first. With it selected, I come here and I click the offset button, and this is going to copy the path length number. And then we need to copy this number with Command or Control C and paste it into the dashes section with Command or Control V. Now, without clicking anything else, it's just a case of moving the timeline slider up to how many seconds you want the animation to run for. So once I've done that, I need to finally set the offset option back to 0, which is going to complete the animation. And to check the animation, drag the slider back to the beginning and then just hit spacebar. It's really that simple, but we've still got some more things to do and there are a few more features to look at. So for the circle, select it and then go back to the button here and set up a stroke offset and stroke dash timelines like we did before. So like we did with the play icon, we need to set the offset length and then copy it into the dash box. For the circle, I'm going to move the timeline a little bit longer as I want to make the animation run for a tiny bit more compared to the play button. And so finally, as we did before, just change the offset number back to 0. We can now drag the slider back and test run the animation to see how it plays out. It is easy to change the start time, the end time, and also the duration of the animation, but I'm not fully happy with the animation of the circle as I feel it could be more dynamic and just a bit more interesting. So what we can do is to head here and grab the transform tool and then drag the crosshair icon to the exact middle of the design. Make sure the slider is set at the start and then head up into the corner. Now hold down shift and then rotate it exactly 180 degrees. We then press shift and R to activate the rotate timeline. And then we can rotate the circle another 180 degrees until we see we've made one full turn. You can see that in the menu here. Now the animation looks slightly different as it isn't just a standard circular animation from start to finish. So yeah, I feel that looks really neat, and for not having any previous experience with animating SVGs, I'm really pleased with this outcome and I think it was really easy to finish actually. Also, of course, you can play around the sliders to affect the animation's length, start point, and so forth. it is really easy to pick up the user face and also the features of SVGator. But the benefits of SVG files is that they tend to look really good on any device, no matter what the size or the resolution is, and they load extremely fast compared to other file formats. That's mainly because it's just code generating the image. In SVGator, we export the SVGs in either CSS or JavaScript. Now, I personally don't have much experience with coding, but I do know enough to apply the code into my website, and for that, I'm going to use JavaScript. Now, once you've exported the SVG file, you can modify the code if you want to, and this will actually change the design itself outside of SVGator and other programs, which is one great use and feature of SVG files. So I'm going to pop into my dated portfolio website that does need a revamp sometime soon when I actually have the time. I've been saying that for ages, but anyway, I can paste the code anywhere I like on my website. Now, giving it a test run, I can see the file is rather larger on my website than I'd like it to be. And so if I wanted to change that, I could just do it in SVGator or I could edit the code itself. And so there is today's video about SVGator and the really easy to use product for animating SVGs. Do check the links below to head over to their website. I've got more useful and in-depth graphic design content coming here on this channel in the coming days and the weeks. So if you haven't done already, do subscribe to my channel to keep updated to all of my graphic design content right here at Satori Graphics. But yeah, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.